Warning, this video is entirely my opinion, so if you don't like opinions, then maybe this isn't the video for you. So, sorry, I guess.
It's the most wonderful time.
Hey, what is up, guys? Welcome back to another video. I'm in a good mood today, guys. You wanna know why? Do you wanna know why I'm in a good mood today? Because it's Christmas.
But have a cup of cheer.
I got a very special video for you guys. Now, for all the years that I've been on this earth, I've watched a lot of Christmas movies over my time. Some of which I've watched more than I probably should have, but you know, what can I say? And today, I'm gonna be rating all of those Christmas movies. I have right here a fat stack of movies. Just droves of movies that I'm gonna be talking about today. Before we jump into this, I do wanna let you guys know I haven't seen every Christmas movie ever, so I don't mean to break your heart, but there might be a movie or two that I don't talk about in here. There's gonna be one comment that's like, you didn't talk about the Minecraft Christmas special from 2015? So, I don't know about you guys, but I think we might wanna just kinda jump into it. Would that be okay with you guys if I just jump into it? So the first movie is one that I am sure 99.9% of you have not seen, but for that 0.1% of you that have seen it and can vouch for me, Santa Claus Conquers the Martians. This is a movie from, I think, the 60s. I believe this movie's from 1963. It is truly just atrocious. It is laughably bad. I can't even begin to describe how awful this movie is. It's funny. But for all the wrong, it's pretty much the Room of Christmas movies. I highly suggest you guys give this a watch. It's terrible, but I love it. Now, the next one I'm going over is probably another one a lot of you guys haven't really heard of before. This is actually the most recent one on this list. This is A Merry Friggin' Christmas with Robin Williams and Joel McHale from Community, The Joel McHale Show, The Soup, The Scoop, The Soup, The Soap? What show is he on? He was on a show with an S word. It was like The Soup or Soap or something. I don't know. I'll put on screen what it actually was. But it kind of hurts to put this movie on here because this is actually one of Robin Williams' last movies. It's really depressing that this is one of his last movies. In my opinion, this is not a very entertaining movie. It's actually surprisingly like just dark. It's like not really funny or lighthearted. And when I'm watching a Christmas movie, I want to be able to take a load off, get myself a hot cup of cocoa, and just watch a fun Christmas movie. And this was not that. Once again, it breaks my heart because I love Robin Williams to death. He's one of my favorite actors of all time, one of my favorite comedians, but he just wasn't very good on this. Also, Joel McHale. I love Joel McHale. The next one that I'm about to talk about also breaks my heart because this is, once again, a movie with an actor in it that I highly respect. The next movie on this list is Ernest Saves Christmas. This is, I believe, from the 80s or early 90s. This one, I'm sure some of you have heard of. It's still kind of a lesser known one. There's actually some questionable stuff that happens in this movie where, like, I don't know. It's a little odd. It's a little weird. If you guys watch it or have watched it, you'll probably know what I'm talking about, but I just don't think this movie really works too much nowadays. Once again, I love the Ernest movies, and I actually do kind of enjoy this movie. Like, I genuinely, like, have a good time watching it. It's just, compared to the other movies, I think this is not a very well-made one. There's some bits. There's this one bit at the end of the movie with this elf lady that's screaming, and I swear to God, every time I watch the movie, I want to strangle her. It is the most infuriating sound on the planet. The next movie we're gonna go over is Jingle All the Way. This is a movie from the 90s. It stars some pretty big names, actually. Sinbad, Jake Lloyd from Phantom Menace, Arnold Schwarzenegger. While I do enjoy this movie, like, I think it's a fun movie. I think compared to the movies I'm gonna be going over later, it's not as well made. It just lacks a certain pizzazz that I kinda want. Like, it's not super rewatchable. And also, the moral of the movie is pretty, I don't know. It's not the type of movie you wanna show your kids. Because it's about robbery. And a Christmas movie I don't think should be about robbery. I think that's not necessarily a good theme to show to your kids. The next movie I'm gonna go over I don't actually own, but I have watched it. It is the Jim Carrey animated Christmas Carol. I think this movie was coming out right around the time that animated movies were kind of at their peak, in my opinion. I think 2009 was a great year for animated movies. We had Up, WALL-E just came out the year before, and of course the Jim Carrey Christmas Carol. I think this movie's pretty good for the most part. Some of the animation I think is kind of spooky. Most Christmas movies are kind of aimed towards kids, and I don't think some of the animation in that movie, it's kind of a scary movie at some points, which I guess that's kind of how Christmas Carol always is. I actually watched it for the first time a couple years ago, and yeah, I enjoyed it. Like, don't get me wrong, I like it. I just don't think it's, compared to the movies I'm about to go over, it's not as good. Now, speaking of Christmas Carol, the next movie that I'm gonna go over is The Muppet Christmas Carol. This one I actually do own. The only reason I'm putting this slightly above is because of that thing of, you know, the imagery in the Jim Carrey Christmas Carol is a little spooky. And I'm not a gigantic fan of the animation in that movie. I think for the most part, it's good. It's well made. It's just, I don't like looking at it. But with this movie, I think it's a lot more lighthearted. I think it's prettier to look at, in my opinion. Plus the Muppets, come on. You can't go wrong with the Muppets. The next movie, once again, I don't own, but I used to on VHS, and that is the Jim Carrey Grinch movie. I enjoy the movie now. I do now. But I did not back in the day. The movie used to give me nightmares. I was horrified of that movie. A lot of the Who's, the way they did the makeup for the Who's in those movies was just very frightening as a kid. It's not nice to look at. I don't like looking at it. The next movie on this list is Charlie Brown Christmas. This is a movie that I watch every year. I love the Charlie Brown movies. I grew up on them. I don't know why I said movies. They're more like short episodes. It has a good message in the movie about, like, you know, that he has the shortest tree, but it ends up making the biggest impact. And I actually have the tree from the movie right over there. I will try to make sure to get a shot of that. But whenever I watch these Charlie Brown movies, I just feel so bad for Charlie Brown. Like, he genuinely is really depressed in these movies, and I feel like, I don't know, obviously it was a different time, but my god, I mean, they're just brutal to him. The next one I'm gonna go over is another classic. Is this the, I don't know if this is the original. I honest to god cannot tell you if this is the original Miracle on 34th Street. I believe it is. I don't know if this is the original one. I could be completely wrong. I'm talking about the original one. The one that everybody remembers. I think it's a really good movie. I've only seen it like once or twice because, to be honest, it's not like one of those movies I just want to like rewatch time and time again. I think it does kind of lack that modern rewatchability that I want. Maybe it's because I'm a stupid zoomer and, you know, I don't like old things, I guess, which I don't know. Now, the next movie on the list is the animated, of course, How the Grinch Stole Christmas. This movie is just a freaking classic. I haven't seen the 2018 one. I don't really have any intention of seeing it because this, in my opinion, is the ideal Grinch movie. If you want a Grinch movie, this is the one. Not the Jim Carrey one, not the 2018 animated one. This one. The animation to this day holds up so well. Like, if you rewatch it, honestly, I remember watching this as a kid and I thought it was made in like the 90s. Now, the next one I'm gonna go over, I feel like I might get attacked for because it won't be my number one, and that is It's a Wonderful Life. I will say, I think of all the movies that I will be talking about or have talked about today, I think this is the best well-made film. I think this is the most solid one. The ending gets me choked up every single time I watch it. It's a fantastic movie, fantastic message. It's really just a super well-made movie. But once again, when I'm watching a Christmas movie, I don't want to be sad when I watch it. And this is a sad movie. I mean, there's some really sad scenes in this movie. So the next one I'm going over is The Polar Express. Now, this movie, I just... talk about animation that holds up. This holds up. This is 2004, I think? Yeah. And it holds up super well. Every movie that I'm about to go over, I think, does a great job at capturing the magic of Christmas. And this is one of those movies. Like, I remember in elementary school, they would show this movie, like, on the last day of school before you get out. I'm sure a lot of you guys had that experience. This was, for some reason, the movie to play. But yeah, this movie does just such a great job at capturing, like, that magical feeling that you had on Christmas night and like kind of what you imagine the North Pole to be. Also, the music in this movie is amazing. Okay, so another movie that just does a great job at capturing that magical feeling is my next movie, The Santa Claus. More like, yes, more Santa Claus. Oh my god. I can't even begin to explain how much I adored this movie. I think this movie, more than any movie on this list, best captures that magical feeling that you had in your stomach when you went to bed Christmas Eve night. And the music in this movie does a really good job at kind of conveying that. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, rewatch the movie. there's this certain track that plays that's like da na 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 na. It plays like on the Christmas Eve night. That soundtrack just like it sends me back. Like it sends me back to 5 years old. And like I feel like a kid when I hear that music. I don't know. It's really hard to explain, guys.
Charlie, stay where you are. Charlie, would you listen to me? Stay up there.
It is Santa. You killed him.
Did not.
Tim Allen's character in this movie, Scott Calvin, like, as you get older, you just relate to him more and more. I love his character in this movie. He's so funny. Say what you will about Tim Allen, okay? He has said some pretty dumb things in recent memory. He's funny in this movie. I think, as a kid, I didn't really appreciate the humor in this movie. Now, the next movie... Come on. Did you think I was gonna not talk about this movie? A Christmas Story. I mean, this movie, I adore this movie. I've watched it once again every single year. I have a tradition where I wake up Christmas morning pretty early with my brothers, and before we open presents, we actually watch the movie Holes, which I know is super random, but then we watch the the marathon of A Christmas Story. You'll shoot your eye out, kid! That's a quote from the movie, if you guys didn't know. But yeah, no, seriously, like, there's so many iconic things in this movie, like the bunny rabbit suit, the Bumpus's dogs, the leg lamp, the obviously you'll shoot your eye out thing, the kid putting his tongue on the pole and getting stuck there, the little brother getting stuck in his suit like that. I mean, God, dude, every scene in this movie is just so, like, legendary at this point. One of my favorite Christmas movies. This is my number two favorite movie. I love this movie to death. We have gotten to the final movie on this list. I know a lot of you guys probably know what this movie is going to be. I don't think this is the best well-made one. I think it's up there. This is my personal favorite Christmas movie of all time. I love it dearly. It is not only one of my favorite Christmas movies, but it is also one of my favorite movies in general. Talking about Elf. I mean, what can I even say about the movie that you don't already know? I mean, this is like, I think this is the most known Christmas movie at this point. I think this one has gained such a notoriety. I think part of it does have to do with, you know, it is the one of the most recent Christmas movies. But my God, I watched this movie again like a week ago. It was just, it's such a well-made, super funny, super lighthearted, surprisingly emotional. Now let me say what I mean by that. I've watched this movie every year since I was a kid, and it never really got me as emotional as it does now. That ending scene, when everybody is singing Santa Claus is Coming to Town, and Santa finally gets enough Christmas spirit to fly over the crowd, and everybody sees Santa for the first time, I cry.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
I'm just gonna be completely honest, all right? I will be the first to admit, I cry while watching Elf. That scene, it just makes me bawl my eyes out. It's a very emotional scene. It just is. I love the idea that Santa's sleigh can't fly unless there's Christmas, like, magic. Like, unless people are believing. I think that's such a cool idea. Also, another thing I think this movie does not get enough credit for is the soundtrack. The soundtrack is fantastic. Buddy the Elf is one of the greatest characters of all time. I love Buddy the Elf. When I was a kid, I wanted to know Buddy the Elf. Will Ferrell, this is one of his best movies, in my opinion. I love this movie. All right, guys, if you enjoyed this video, like, comment, subscribe, do all that amazing stuff, and, well, I'll see you guys in the future.